from 80s pin-up extraordinaire Page Three eye-popper and pop sensation Samantha
Thank you
Pott.
Very much. And you must be Roger and you must be Podge.
Indeed.
Is that right?
That's right.
Well done.
Sam okay. Fox in 3D. I can't believe it. Three double D, brother. What? Now, Sam, you, Lady Di, and Margaret Thatcher are Britain's most photographed women. Isn't that amazing?
I mean, well, yeah, it was up until a few years ago, but not so much these days. But no, it was an amazing time for me during that time.
Oh, sure it was.
It wasn't a day that went by where there wasn't nobody following me with
following
cameras.
Following you around, the paparazzi and all that.
Oh, yes, the paparazzi. They're stalking me in the garden.
Were they?
Hanging out your washing, and there they are. That, but, you know, that
was me.
Yeah,
that was that you?
Yeah. That was right.
I thought so. I recognised the air sticking out from the bush. Yeah,
yeah. But listen, you basically revolutionised the Page Three. Well, did I miss the bush joke?
Sorry, Charlie. What did you ask me again? Sorry.
Well, no, I was going to say that you basically revolutionised the Page Three in the 80s.
I like to think so. I like to think so because in the old days, before I came along, it was very difficult for Page Three girls to get on television or be used for endorsements and things like that. And then one day I got asked to go on the Terry Wogan show.
Ooh.
And it kind of propelled me into different things.
Different level,
yeah. I became a TV presenter for about 18 months. Yeah. And I set up my own company, Sam Fox Enterprises.
Right.
No, it was an amazing time, it really was.
Great. But you sent a trouser thrill to millions of men on a daily basis.
I'm really glad that you know, I helped a lot of young boys grow up. I think it's a good thing. Did I help you grow up at all?
Oh yeah,
we grew up all right.
Wow. So how on earth did you get started in the glamour modelling business?
There was a competition in the Sunday People.
Right.
And it said, girls, you can be the face and shape of 1983.
Right.
Ooh.
And it said, boyfriends, mums, dads, if you know anybody who, you know, could be the face and shape, send in a picture. Right. So my mum just sent in, it wasn't a topless picture.
Right, just an ordinary one.
Well, it wasn't that ordinary. I was wearing a really lovely basque, a Victorian basque. To show my figure, obviously, because that was what it was about.
Nice.
And, I got picked out of 4,000 girls.
When did they ask, would the fox get the cubs out?
Actually, it was on the day of the competition. I'd reached, it was the first stage where I'd reached the final 20.
Right.
And the photographer said to me, I think you'd make a fantastic Page Three girl.
Ooh.
And I was like, oh, really? Better ring me dad first, you know.
Right, yeah, better check.
And, we discussed it with me and my family, and then we did some pictures, and he said they wouldn't be seen until after the competition.
Mm.
But obviously they were.
They were, yeah.
They were put on the front page when we went to war with the Falklands.
Oh, right.
And it said... I know, yeah. It was put on the front page and it went SOS Sam Fox, because apparently all the boys in the Falklands wanted more pictures of me.
Of course they did. Is it true that you insured your boobs for $250,000?
I did at the time. Yeah, $250,000 each. Yeah, that's
right.
Was
it just for fire and theft, or did you go fully comprehensive?
It was fire. It's just so funny. It's so funny. It was with Lloyd Underwriters, and one of the things that I couldn't do was any fire eating. I mean, as if I would, you know. And fire eating and sunbathing topless, which was quite difficult because when I used to turn up for photo shoots, my boobs would be white and my body would be brown, so I had to put stuff in them, you know. Tan.
Did you need anyone to give you a hand with that?
Well, no, yeah, I had a lot of offers, you know.
Yeah, you did.
Come here, are they still 100% real?
Yes.
Oh.
And they still defy gravity, which I'm really pleased about. They're still not leaning on the kitchen table, do you know what I mean?
No, they're very nice indeed. What do you make of the plastic? What do you make of the plastic boob craze that's taken over nowadays, though?
I think it's obviously a personal choice, but I guess.
sorry, hold on a second, Raj.
It's him, look. Do you need glasses?
Raj,
or
come back, huh? Come back to us now. Come back.
All right. Yes. Sorry. Was he?
Come on,
Raj. I did. Sorry. I didn't mean to stare now. Sorry about that.
You've got to concentrate now.
Yeah. See, right, go ahead.
You put me off.
I've asked your question already.
Get down.
Plastic boobs. What do you make of them?
It's a dog. Yeah, sorry.
You sure you might need that? Sure.
Sam, don't encourage him, honestly.
I know. Right.
What do you make of the plastic boob craze?
Again, I think it's a personal choice. And I guess if I was a young woman who wasn't happy with my breasts, and I could pay for a pair, then yeah, I'm sure I would.
But most of the ones in the magazines now have got them, like,
Big silicone ones jumping out at you.
Yeah, I guess some of them are a bit too big, but again, it's choice.
Now listen, your other career.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Your other career, right, which made you a truly international star, was your music.
The music.
How did you make the transition from getting your tits out to getting the hits out?
It was quite easy, really. Before I was a pastry girl, I was in a band called SFX.
Oh. Right.
Yeah, and then when I was like 15, and we played all over England, and we had one single out and it got to about 42 or something like that.
Oh, well, God, you did a little better now when you signed with the Stock Aitken Waterman's.
Yeah, well, exactly. But the only thing about Stock Aitken Waterman, they never really broke America, did they? They were really big in Europe.
That's right.
Yeah. Now, listen, the big one has to be, right? Touch me!
Yes.
I want to feel your body!
Your heartbeat next to mine.
Oh, come on, look.
Now, I think we've just plain rude not to show a bit.
It would be rude not to show a bit. Come on, let's have a look at it.
Let's have some memories.
Touch me, I want to feel your body. Your heartbeat next to mine. I want your body all the time. Touch me.
That was my first single. That was in, 1986. That's a long time.
Oh, it had a great beat, though.
Great beat, though.
And a good message as well.
Definitely. I mean, it's very international, isn't it? Touch me. Everybody understands it. Every country I go to, they just understand it. It's, touch me, it works.
Touch your body.
That's how we all got here, isn't it, really?
Right, indeed.
I think.
Now, even when you were a bona fide pop star, the calls for the glamour shots didn't end. And I believe you did the Playboy.
I did, when I reached 30, yeah.
Wow.
No, it was good. It was a good shoot.
Yeah.
You know what?
Was it good?
Yeah, I liked it. I was able to... there was a particular photographer that I'd always wanted to work with.
Right.
Who'd done, beautiful nude shots. Yeah, I mean, there's nude and there's nude, and there's a thin line you don't cross.
Yeah.
You know that kind of nude, I mean, don't you?
Oh, yeah, no, we... I think you like that kind of nude, don't you? Raj does, we both do. But yes, look, there's a problem, we never got
to
see it.
No, you see, the thing about it is,
can you see it?
No.
No, because Playboy, right, dirty picture books, like, were illegal in Ireland.
Illegal?
Right, here, for years. But
I bet you had some under your bed, though, didn't you?
Well, this is the problem. Right, we heard that you were in it, right, in the Playboy, so we sent a fella off on the boat to England to pick up a copy, right? It took him 2 weeks to come back.
Yeah.
But all the pages were stuck together.
Oh.
As he claimed... No, he claimed it was a very lonely trip, you see.
And Sam, let me tell you, 3 weeks of steaming couldn't pry those pages open. So we never got to see the fox's den.
Apparently you can... stop it now. It was only from the side, kind of.
Did you not see the bush?
Yeah.
Oh, you did?
But, you know...
Oh, in profile?
Not like in your face, like, kind of. I'm just digging a bigger hole here, ain't I?
A bigger hole?
Oh, no! Oh, dear. I'm a bit slow today. What's going on?
Now, listen.
Pardon?
We believe, for the meal of life, you've chosen the vegetarian option.
Is that true?
Pardon?
When did you discover that you like to get licky-licky with the ladies? Wait, was the
when I fell in love with one,
right,
basically.
Yeah, that's what you mean.
Yes, no.
When I fell in love.
But were you lazy all along, or did it just... What?
I'm not really into labels. I don't believe in labels. I believe in love, and I met somebody, and I fell in love instantly, and I fell in love with a person.
Right,
yeah.
And I'm sure there's a lot of people like me out there, really. Not quite sure how to put it, but... I met someone I knew I wanted to spend the rest of my life with, yeah.
Come here, when's the autobiography coming out? Because you've lived an incredible life so far.
I have, yes.
Have you written one?
It's just taking so long to write.
It'll be out this year.
It's all about timing with books. I reckon it'll be out for next Christmas.
Good.
I really hope so.
Put lots of pictures in it, won't
you? Lots of pictures.
Just for you, there's a special edition.
Nice.
Rodge and Podge edition.
The Rodge and Podge edition.
With a white, clean cover. That's what we need.
Yes. Yeah. With special pages. Stop it now.
Well, listen, the many years of pleasure have been all ours.
They have.
The foxiest fox of them all.
Absolutely. Sam Fox, everyone.
Thank you.
Gorgeous.